think the biggest challenge that we're facing right now is the fact that our entire retail had seen a complete shutdown, which obviously led to a drastic drop in demand. And, you know, keeping the company afloat with almost a zero revenue situation has obviously been a massive concern and has taken the toll on the financial health of the company. But I think one of the ways that we've sort of decided how to cope and both utilize this time is actually to train our, you know, HR. It's been really about educating our entire team in terms of, you know, things that we never got to do. So, for example, giving them more in-depth product knowledge, making them understand the inspiration for our design so that they're better equipped to actually speak to both customers, architects and interior designers alike. We've also used this time to do a lot of, I think, background research on new designs that we want to be launching going forward, because I think this downtime is a great way for us to, you know, really spend time evaluating what is missing in our portfolio, creating, you know, an entire new collection. And I think this is going to be really exciting for sort of the post-COVID scenario, because we'll be geared up to offer a lot more to our customers.
At the moment, we are in uncharted territory. Businesses like mine have all their production units shut. Clients are uncertain about confirming new orders while the overheads still continue. The infrastructure we all depend on to ensure the production process runs smoothly have been badly affected, and there is fear that even when the industry does start to resume, it'll be hard for businesses to operate smoothly and optimally.
I think as designers working in the lighting and product space, we have to find new ways to expand our outreach. Social media is going to become extremely important. Exploring more platforms beyond Instagram become an interesting challenge. One more focus that we as designers have to do is look beyond urban centers, expand to tier 2, tier 3 cities. A lot of development is going to be happening in the smaller towns within the country, and we have a population of 1 billion+ people. So we have almost like a micro economy that we can try and cater our services to. Reaching out to smaller design communities in these cities becomes great focus for us moving forward.